Today we're going to replace the brake lever on a Sunseeker Eco-Delta. We need a couple things: a 5mm Allen wrench, a 3mm Allen wrench, a 2.5, a razor blade can be handy, some spare zip ties for redoing the cables. Here's our new grip. Here's our new brake lever. Here's a hammer that we're going to use to put the new grips on, and a pair of side cutters or some scissors or something for cutting the zip ties. To get started here, Cliff is going to show us. You can try to pull and twist and get this guy off. Compressed air and a blow-off nozzle can help, but honestly the most efficient way to do it is just take a razor blade and cut it. Since the new grip's going over top, the mark on the handlebars won't be seen. So we put a razor blade on, and so we're cutting just the grip here. We're not cutting the twist throttle there, the grip shift throttle. Cutting just the grip. Usually you've got to score it twice or even more in order to get it all the way open. Since it's so thick, you just run the blade across it a couple times. You can see here the split in it that let us pull it off. Now we're going to take our 2.5mm Allen wrench and we're going to get in the split clamp for the twist grip shifter on the right hand, and we're going to undo that split clamp, and that'll let us slide the shifter out. If you don't have quite enough slack in the cables, now it's time to cut a zip tie. Now we've got just about enough slack. We may need to cut a second zip tie or move it in order to move the shifter off. Now we can let the shifter hang while we work. And we're going to do the same on the throttle. 3mm Allen wrench. We're going to loosen the split clamp. And again, just a couple of turns to loosen it. You do not want to completely take the screw out. And then don't forget that there's a washer that goes in the end of this throttle. You want to get the washer back in when you're putting it back on and make sure the throttle doesn't stick. Now we've got our 5mm Allen wrench and we can work on the brake. It may be easier before removing the brake lever to do the cable though. Let's leave the brake on. So we're going to turn the barrel adjuster all the way clockwise. This is in two parts. So the barrel adjuster here tightens the cable by pushing against the housing. It's got a lock nut on it, which locks the barrel in place. If Cliff, you'll show how the lock nut. So the lock nut threads all the way against the lever body normally, locking this in place. So you want to turn this counterclockwise. You see just the lock nut piece to get everything loose so that you can, once you have the lock nut against the barrel adjuster, now you can turn the barrel adjuster all the way in clockwise here to loosen the cable as much as you can. And then line the split in both of them up with the split in the lever housing. Can you turn this one, Cliff? Once you line the split up with the housing, you'll be able to remove the cable. So you can see you've got to turn them until this is lined up here. Now, with any luck, when each of these parts is lined up, so you have a continuous split through there, with any luck, you can pull the housing backwards and pull the cable through the split and lift it out of the anchor. This will depend on the adjustment of the brake though, so let's put it back in and show how to remove the cable from the caliper in case you don't have enough slack to do this by hand. So let's say we've got this adjusted to where we can try to remove it, but pull on the housing here, Cliff. We can't pull enough to get it out. It's stuck. We go to the back of the bike, to the brake caliper back here, and we'll find the cable anchor on the brake caliper. We've got a barrel adjuster back here as well, so in the same vein, we can turn this clockwise after loosening the lock nut several turns until we can hopefully pull it out up top. If we still can't pull it out up top, now it's time to, so we can take a look, so you can see maybe we can pull it out up top, but maybe it's still too tight. So if it's still too tight to pull it out, we'll need to loosen the cable anchor. So we'll put this back in, and once more, so say, after loosening both barrel adjusters. So we've loosened both barrel adjusters, the housing is still too tight, we still can't pull it out of the split, so we're going to come down here and we're going to loosen with our 5mm Allen wrench the cable anchor here. So we loosen this screw just a couple of turns. You'll notice when it's loose, the cable will slip. We can pull the cable backwards, lengthening the cable, and now we'll definitely be able to pull the housing right out. So try both barrel adjusters first. In all probability, you'll be able to take this out. If not, loosen the anchor. Now we can pull the cable out. And now we're ready to unplug the red brake connector, the electrical cable from the brake. We've got that unplugged. We can loosen the clamp on the brake and slide the brake off. Now we'll grab our new brake. We're going to slide our new brake on. Once we've got our new brake on, we tighten up the split clamp. Now that we've got it, we can pull the new cable in place once we line the split up once more. So you see we line the split up like we did on the original one. I've just messed up the adjustment here, Cliff. Can you grab the top piece? There you are. So you can see we've got the split, and we're going to put the cable in its anchor and pull the housing in place. There we go. When we let go, we've got the cable in. Cliff is going to tighten the barrel adjuster just a tiny bit there. If we've taken it off the brake caliper, now we need to pull tension into the cable by pulling the cable out the back. When you're pulling in the tension, make sure that the cable housing sits down in there. Now we can tension the cable slightly and tighten up the cable anchor. Once we've got the cable anchor fully tightened, we can take a look at the brake. We want to just see that the brake pads are not dragging yet, and we can adjust the lever for feel later by tightening the two barrel adjusters. In both cases, they'll tighten the brake if you turn them counterclockwise as though you're loosening a screw. Like this, that will tighten your brake so it'll engage sooner when you pull the lever. So we'll take a look up top, and it's time to start putting stuff back on. Slide the throttle in place. Now Cliff is working here. I'm going to get him a washer for his throttle. This guy will slide in place. Got to make sure that's in there to prevent the throttle from sticking against the twist grip shifter. Now we'll slide the shifter on. Notice we're running the cable under the brake lever. Now I can tighten the twist shifter back in place. Once we've got the shifter and the throttle tightened in place, we want to check and make sure that the throttle is springing home. It's not sticking anywhere. This is looking good. You notice there's a small gap between the throttle and the shifter so that they can't stick against each other. And now we'll want to hammer the grip on. A little bit of Windex will make this easier. You just squirt a little bit on the bars, and if you haven't got it, you can just hit it with the hammer a good bit. Even with the Windex, you'll need a hammer. Notice Cliff holds the bars still while he hammers it in place. And we were a little optimistic about our placement of each piece, so now we're going to rearrange them so that there's not a gap there. So we're going to slide each piece over in order to make sure that it fits nicely. Now we are all set. Make sure our barrel adjusters are locked down in place, our brake lever's feeling about right, and we're ready to go.